Okay, discuss this problem. So 16.68. So what this problem says, we have benzaldehyde, not benzaldehyde, we have benzyl bromide, CH2Br. So this group is called benzyl group, we have already discussed. And we have a bromine derivative of benzyl, so this is why this is called benzyl bromide. Now question says, if you treat benzyl bromide with dimethyl sulfoxide, that is DMSO, CH3SO, that is DMSO, we have already said, dimethyl sulfoxide, if you treat with dimethyl sulfoxide, SN2 reaction takes place. It is given to you. SN2 reaction takes place. And you get intermediate A. So you are getting an intermediate A. So A is basically an intermediate. This means it will react in the next step. So this is an intermediate. So this is your intermediate. This means if you react benzyl bromide with DMSO, SN2 reaction takes place and you get an intermediate. Now this intermediate is not a stable intermediate. This dissociates in the next step in the presence of base. So if you have some base, elimination happens, E2. Elimination reaction, E2 reaction, you can write. E2 reaction happens. And finally it gives benzaldehyde, PHCHO. So this is your benzaldehyde. So finally you are getting benzaldehyde. So basically you have to write down the mechanism for this reaction. So in the first step, it reacts with DMSO via SN2 mechanism and gives an intermediate A. And this intermediate is basically not a stable. If the medium contains some bases, or medium is slightly basic and heating is also slightly there, this means temperature is not too low. If temperature is high slightly, this intermediate goes through E2 elimination reaction, and after E2 elimination it gives benzaldehyde as one product. You have to suggest me the mechanism for this reaction. And hint given is, dimethyl sulfoxide has a resonating structure. If you see CH3SO, CH3, there are two lone pair of electrons. Now this does not look like a nucleophile, but if you write something like this, another resonating structure of the same molecule. If you write CH3SO-, CH3, there is a plus charge, basically there are two electrons everywhere on sulfur. So you will have minus charge on oxygen. Are you getting? So now this looks like a good nucleophile. Oxygen can attack as a nucleophile. So first part is easy. You take oxygen as a nucleophile, attack and do the SN2 product. Next step is also easy. You just remove one H+ and some leaving group is there. Then you will get the product as a benzaldehyde. So let me wait for 50 seconds. 50 seconds you have to draw the answer. Okay, I think some of you have done this one. So let us see. So you have a nucleophile. So this O, SO minus, CH3, and sulfur have a positive charge. So this nucleophile will attack here. CH2Br you have. So first step is easy. So you have O minus. So this nucleophile will attack here and Br will go. So you will have. So this CH2 will have now this group. Br has gone. So you will have pH. CH2 and then you will have O and sulfur. And this sulfur will have attached to two methyl groups. So you will have one methyl group up. You can write one methyl group here. So this sulfur will also have a positive charge. So this is the intermediate you will have. Now the next step is quite easy step. You have to lose an H plus and one leaving group so that you have the final product. So let us say the second step. You have this molecule OSME plus charge. Now so easy reaction. This is a elimination reaction. Did you remember some revised elimination? What happens in an elimination reaction? Let us write on the supplement. You have HX. What happens in elimination reaction? You have a base minus. This base minus takes H plus. This goes here. This goes here. So this is all about the elimination reaction. E2 reaction. Are you getting it? So this is the crux of E2 reaction. You can have same thing here. Now you see. What can you do is. You can have positive charge on sulfur. This can be removed by putting this lone bond pair here. Now sulfur has no negative charge if you break the bond something like this. Once you are breaking this bond, now oxygen will have a formal positive charge. So to do this, I have to remove this. Are you getting or not? And H plus can be taken by base. So there is a base that can take H plus. So base will take H plus, this one will go here and this one will go here. So simple, it's something like elimination. You see what happens. You have carbon, next carbon. But only thing is here you have a carbon. And next you don't have carbon. The leaving group is attached to the oxygen. So this is the leaving group. So this part is the leaving group. You getting or not? So this is leaving group. And this is H plus. Same thing. You have carbon, oxygen, leaving group. So what you have? You have unit. Hydrogen, carbon, carbon, leaving group. Here you have. Hydrogen, carbon, not carbon. Oxygen, leaving group. Hydrogen, carbon, oxygen, leaving group. Same unit. You see. The unit here. You have hydrogen, carbon, carbon, leaving group. You have the same unit here. Hydrogen, carbon, oxygen, leaving group. The same thing if I follow, I will get benzaldehyde. So if you do the things, you will get benzaldehyde. And plus you will get CH3SCH3. That is, you will have another product, MESME. And now two lone pair. One lone pair was earlier and one lone pair is coming, so no formal charge. So this will, the side product you will get. So main product is benzaldehyde. So you are getting the benzaldehyde as the main product. Let us copy this one and then we'll go for the next problem. Okay, I think all of you have done. Let us go for the next problem.